staff of the Ferguson Police Department. I asked him that question directly. He said, oh, no, I can't confirm that.
Andy, it looks like there's a crowd growing, and we just saw a man out in the street. It looks like he's yelling toward police.
Yes. Man in a red shirt.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Standing there. Yeah.
And more
screaming
people
obscenities. They're not coming at him, and now it looks like they're backing up some more cameras.
And this, again, this is all live. This is live TV, and you're watching this unfold. So we're trying to keep a listen on exactly what people are saying, but it is live TV. So we want to kind of warn people that things can be said live on the air that you can't control. And this is a very highly, highly emotional situation. And you can see from this live picture, people just standing there looking as police in the riot gear they have a defined line on West Florissant. This is right next to that Quick Trip that was looted and burned. And right now we're just kind of in a holding pattern, and we haven't heard of any injuries. Yeah, Andy, go ahead. Do you have anything else to add?
Yeah, I was just going to say it's hard for the people out here because tensions are so high and the lines are blurred. And I made that point that police officers aren't out here, and the TAC squad, you know, the people from St. Louis City and from the state police. I saw some from Charlac out here earlier, St. Louis County. Probably all hands on deck for St. Louis County.
Well, there really is,
they're
Andy. I know there's Maryland Heights officers. There's a lot. Police officers from all over these municipalities are there.
They're not out here to try to prove a point about, the shooting death of 18-year-old Michael Brown that precipitated all of this. They're here to keep the peace. They're here to protect the people who live in Ferguson right now. That's what they're here for. They're not here trying to make a point and stand by one of their own. This is not something you do out of police code. This is about protecting the public.
All right, Andy Baker.
That's a message that needs to get out. And you understand people are upset about what happened. I'm not preaching here. I'm saying what it is, and I just hope people keep that in mind.
All right. Andy Baker.